Hello everyone, welcome to iTeachPetIndustriesHelpingHands.com. So here we are with interview experience show with our guest is Janvi. She is placed in IBM as associate system engineer. Actually she was placed in two other companies also, in Accenture as well as in Infosys, but she had chosen IBM. So let's see what is the difference in the IBM. We are coming with pre-placement workshops and pre-placement courses. So if you are interested to join that, link is below, fill the Google form so that we will approach you. And for further details, as we know, Industries Helping Hands are allied with many companies. We are also conducting the pre-placement talk session in which students are getting to directly interact with the HR of the companies. So stay connected with us. And don't forget to join our WhatsApp group and Telegram channel so that you will never miss an update from our side. And don't forget to click the bell icon and subscribe our YouTube channel. So here we have with us Janvi. She is Associate System Engineer in IBM. Is it Janvi?
Yeah. Hello everyone, this is Janvi and I'm from IBM as Associate System Engineer.
So, Janvi, describe about you, how you have completed your schooling and why you chose this branch. Describe me from the schooling side. What was your teacher in class 11-12?
Okay, my schooling is from Sri Chaitanya Schools and as well as my intermediate as well. I have scored 10 out of 10 in my schooling and around 9.8 in my intermediate. I'm from MPC branch, Maths, Physics and Chemistry. And in the BTech, I have joined in BML Munjal University, which is located in Gurgaon, Haryana.
Okay.
And my branch is ECE, Electronics and Communication Engineering.
Okay. And yeah. This school?
Sorry?
Schooling is from which school?
Sri Chaitanya Techno Schools.
Okay. And which state and which district?
I'm from Rajahmundry, Andhra Pradesh.
Okay. Fine.
Yeah.
So after schooling, why you decided for engineering only?
I'm always interested in engineering and all the connected subjects. So I've chosen engineering.
Okay. So your branch was?
Electronics and Communications.
So it means you from electronics field, you switched to the software field, right?
Yeah.
So particularly how you prepared for this means for coding section and all?
Yeah, that is because I am always interested in the electronic side, but that doesn't mean I was not interested in the software, because even in my graduating time, I have chosen Python and C languages as my electives, so I can prepare for my programming. So there is always a side in me which goes towards the software, but I also like the hardware side.
Okay, means do you have any idea about that power system and the PCB? You have never participated
in
the
software, right? Okay.
So what was your aggregate in your engineering?
That was a funny story, because I was started with 6 in my first year and then ended with 9, so it's in the between, 7.5.
No, practical knowledge, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, and after this, you have described me about how your engineering life was, means your semester, your CTs and your assignments. It was, because engineering 4 years life is, it is entirely full of everything, like good moments, happy
to me, depression. Yeah. To me, engineering was all fun, actually, because our college is real fun, but I missed my last year due to this pandemic.
Okay, yes, everything was virtual.
Yeah, everything was virtual, but we still maintain to have fun, because just like as the software industries, our college was 5 days a week, so every weekend we used to go out or chill at some places.
Okay, in your college it was 5 days working days, Saturdays and off, right?
Yeah, off.
At least in every day or particular second, fourth Saturday like that?
No, every Saturday. And even on Wednesdays, it's half days.
Okay, that's fine, because
it's there it's not just about studies. We have everything there.
Okay, fine. So Janvi, means how you resided there in hostel or PG?
No, it's actually a residential campus, so I have stayed at the hostel.
Describe me about your hostel life. How it was?
Hostel, we used to be in the single rooms, but we used to have a common hall in each apartment. So it's really fun having our private life as well as connecting each other in the each apartment. Mm-hmm. And we used to have the great food. Which I miss the most right now.
Yes, definitely. Hostel life is a moment of our life. It is a memorable time, right?
Yeah, it's really memorable.
Yes. So, how means your preparation and how you manage your studies in your hostel life? Means sometimes it's difficult to prepare for exams in hostel. Some issues are there, like your partner is not good, like something like that. So, how it works? How you manage your studies in your hostel time?
Yeah, unfortunately my friends are really comfortable to me. My classmate used to be in front of my room, so every time we have the exams, we used to separate the chapters and we used to study and we used to explain each other. And most of the time we as a gang used to go to the library and we used to have some small rooms, so in that we used to share all our thoughts and study.
Means you enjoy the group studies there, right?
Yeah. It's not like group studies, but we used to study individually and explain each other so that we can understand better.
Yeah, definitely. That is,
yeah.
Understanding from friends is more important than when teacher is explaining and when friends is explaining, that is a whole different, right?
Yeah.
So that was from your graduation life, right?
Yeah, that I have missed a lot in pandemic, but we used to manage by studying in Google Meet also.
You utilize it fully, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so after you were selected in this IBM, through off-campus or on-campus?
It's off-campus.
Okay. So, any company you faced during your on-campus?
Yeah, I faced a few companies, but I always wanted to join in MNC, but although I have selected in Accenture as well, but IBM is like so much a brand to me, and who doesn't want to join IBM when you've got one?
Exactly. So,
why
did you Accenture? What was the post? What was the profile
you were selected? Yeah, it is also the same post, associate system engineer as well. Software engineer, sorry, associate software engineer, and then this is associate system engineer.
So, what was your package in Accenture?
It was 4.5 lakhs.
And what's your current package?
It's 4.25.
Okay, but
it's all brand new. Yeah, and also it's all the benefits you get in the IBM, and it's so much good because there's so much knowledge you can acquire here. Yeah.
It's after the fresher, I think learning is more important than money and other things.
Yeah.
So, what is the location of
the site? Yeah, at present it is Bangalore.
Okay. And for Accenture, what it was?
Bangalore.
Okay, fine. So there also you are residing in hostel, right?
No, I didn't go there yet.
Okay, and it was from home, is it?
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. You are enjoying at home and working
well. Yeah.
Okay. And how you manage your projects in your semester, means your engineering projects, what was related?
I did so many actually, because for every summer I used to do an internship. I used to go somewhere, mostly in the government organizations. In my winter holidays in the second year, I have gone to steel plant in Visakhapatnam, and in summer I have gone to ECIL, Electronics Corporation of India Limited, in Hyderabad. And in the third year, it's the corona time, so I didn't go anywhere. And then in my final semester, I've gone to BDL, Bharat Dynamics Limited in Hyderabad.
Okay. And what you learned from there means first internship was, I think, Visakhapatnam, right? Visakhapatnam.
Yeah.
So, it was a plant. It was not related software. So, what you learned from there?
But there I've been in the IT department, actually.
Okay.
Yeah. We have done something, a project based on the data visualization.
Okay, okay. So what was your data visualization? They provided you data and you were rectifying and then you were giving it to them.
It's not like that. It's a real-time project. We actually help them do this.
Okay.
So it's regarding the vagal number detection, because there will be so many trains going in and out. So we will be collecting the data information with our numbers written on the train.
Okay, okay, fine. Yeah. Collecting the data and processing it. And
yeah.
Okay, means you are helping the industries, right?
Yeah.
And what was your second internship was from ECI?
ECI, right. Yeah. Then it was like the normal project. We have done electronics voting machine.
Okay.
I think you might have heard about it, like voting. Yeah.
It's an EVM machine, right?
Electronics voting. Yeah, EVM machine,
so
right.
Means you collected the data or something like that from, you learn coding or something?
Actually, I've done it like both EC and CSE mix, because I've done it on the FPGA.
Okay, FPGA, right. Okay.
Yeah.
It is a part of
VLSI,
right?
Yes. You have so much knowledge.
Oh, I don't have much knowledge, but I don't have basic idea about everything.
That's great.
Also, for electronics, instrumentation and all, basic idea I have. So, FPGA, I think it is related to designing of chip. It's something like that.
Yeah.
So, can you describe me more about it so that our electronics student can learn me and generate the enthusiasm?
Cried about it. Actually, I don't remember much about it. It's long back. The same project I've also done in two languages, like Verilog and VHDL. The same project I have continued in my college as well, because we can use it for our student elections also.
Yes, yes. You're using
real time
using your projects also, right?
Yeah.
That's cool. And after ECIL, your third internship was from?
BDL. That was actually, my part is very small in that, but because it was something around about the rockets that we are preparing, I can't give them much information about it, but my part was some coding implementation in that rockets.
Okay, means you help in coding or like testing, or you're just seeing the software coding, right? Like that.
Yeah.
So that means designing of rocket means software software part, like
not the complete rocket. It's like the IMU part, which is the inertial measurement unit.
Okay.
And that is said as the brain of the rocket, means it will tell you where the rocket is, how it is going and everything. So that part, in that part, a small coding part was mine. That's it.
Okay, fine. So that
yeah.
is your internship part. Okay, so after internship, how many interviews you faced and you failed? So one you gave Accenture and you placed in that, right? How many interviews from on campus?
On campus I've given around 3-4, I guess.
Okay, 3-4 means which interview it was?
One is NewGen, one is Smart Energy Water.
Okay, so why you rejected that? Means why you are not selected for that?
Actually, I don't know why I didn't select for that. But for the in the technical round, and in SEW, I didn't select because it was my first interview and I was so terrified. And through off campus also, I have attended Mindtree, and the same problem have occurred. I've been so terrified. That's why I know I'm not getting it. That, so I don't know why that came. I was so tensed.
Okay.
I cleared all the before rounds, but in the interview round, I got rejected.
Okay, means that you faced the other. Your college belongs to a very good institute, very renowned institute. That a very good campus placement is from there, right? But you still choose off campus of IBM, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so this was the three interviews you faced in your on campus. Fourth was of Accenture, right?
Yeah, I faced Accenture and then IBM.
Okay, IBM.
Actually, I had both the interviews on the same day.
Which interview was on the same day? Which two?
Accenture and IBM.
Okay. So, and you attended both?
Yeah, one is in the morning, one is in the evening. I think my day was so fortunate that day.
So that was a lucky day, means you selected in two interviews.
Yeah.
prepare for this particularly? IBM means technical round and HR round. How you prepare them?
Actually, they have first told me that there will be two different rounds for technical and HR. But unfortunately, for me, I think we have done in the one interview.
Okay.
Only one person interviewed me.
Okay, one person at a time, how you prepared for technical section?
Yeah, actually, you see, in your class, there will be one person who will be writing notes for everything they know, everything.
Exactly.
It was me.
Okay, you are studious, means.
I'm not studious, but I like to write, I like to be organized. So, everything I read, I write.
So, help me to prepare for interviews and all technical sections.
Yeah. I shouldn't say this, but my notes was helpful for many teachers also.
Okay, means you didn't follow any platform like any courses or something like that for preparation?
I've done few courses in Coursera. And also, I've gone through so many websites, not single one. I've gone through so many websites, so many YouTube links, and I've collected data and kept in one order. I've gone through some basic concepts of the CSE department like OOPs, data structures, and then some other like BBMS and OOP, that's it.
Means from electronics
and
to gradually switching the software section, right?
Yeah.
That's good. And there also you interested and you learn everywhere, right? That's good.
Yeah.
Okay, so there also
It's never too old to learn, right?
Okay, yes.
When you're interested, you can learn.
Yes, definitely.
It inspires you to learn.
Which course you join in Coursera?
It is Python programming data visualization.
Okay, and that course is of means particular week or course like test you have to give and you have to qualify that, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, fine. So you have knowledge of Python, basic C you have, and what other languages you know?
C and Java.
C and Java, okay. So how do Java help? Means you learn Java from where? Means you learn Python?
Actually, I have learned Java after the interview.
Okay, means you are placed but still you are trying to learn different languages, right?
Because my interview was in June and I got the results in August or something. So there's lot much of time, so what to do in that time? I know I cracked the interview, I'm confident about that. So I started learning some other things.
Okay, that's fine too. And so after that you learn the courses and after placing in the IBM also you try for other companies also or you stop there only?
I've tried for Infosys as well. I've selected in that too.
Okay, means you selected in Accenture, you selected in IBM and
Infosys.
Okay, and
what's your profile here? I don't remember that. I was not so particular about that because I got these. So I was not so particular about that. I just gave it normally.
Okay.
Yeah.
So means you prepared, means you whatever you learn, you applied there, and that was only few successes. You prepare everything online or some offline courses or something like that?
Online.
Okay. Any test series you followed?
Sorry,
any test series you followed?
The programming I've learned in HackerRank.
HackerRank, okay.
Yeah.
Test series it is, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And for non-technical part, like for aptitude reasoning, you followed something?
Actually, for the non-technical part, I need to thank my college because we used to have so many presentation things. We used to have so many soft skills tasks every time we in every semester we have one soft skill subject, and they made us so ready to face the companies or face the world.
Okay. Means the class you joined in the last semester or from third year or from beginning only?
From the beginning, we used to have one soft skill subject in each semester.
Okay, that's cool. Means your college supported you,
you are so much.
Also, and that's all in a combination of all the combination.
And it's not an elective subject.
Okay, it is compulsory subject. That is the main reason, because some students are not taking it seriously enough, so that the college should take the initiative on that, right?
Yeah.
And how you applied for off campus?
I've gone through some websites, so many websites. I don't really quite remember which one, because I used to go what are the openings for freshers in many websites.
You applied for so many companies, right?
Yeah, I applied for so many companies.
And approximately how many calls you received?
Only some have replied back. Some used doesn't at all. I have written exams for around 5 to 6 companies. And I got for interview only these 3, Accenture, IBM, and Infosys.
Means you are selected five, six interviews you faced, and you are selected in 3, right?
Yeah.
So, and means before your campus, have you thought ever about further studies and your masters and other thing?
Yeah, I have thought about it. Though I do it, I may go through the company to the masters now also, but I'm not quite sure. I'm just still like this, but I don't know. We'll see. Anything could happen, but I'm interested in doing masters. What?
You are going through the flow means after graduation, please.
Yeah.
And still, are you preparing for something else?
No, not right now. I'm just concentrating on my job right now. I'm interested in masters.
Okay. You have interest. So, yeah. Which field you are interested for masters?
Data science.
Okay, that is a trending one, is it?
Yeah. Even now, I'm in the domain called data engineer, master data management. So I think it might help me go through the data science as well.
So you are preparing for GATE or something, means particular entrance exam for this particular master courses?
Not right now, but I should actually.
Okay. So how is your life going on as this company? I think the training might have started, is it?
My induction sessions are done. My training is yet to start. I think it will be starting from this week or next week.
Okay, so how your induction program can be served? It was virtual, is it?
Yeah, it's all virtual.
Okay, so means you all the students, those who are placed, were in the same platform or one-to-one interaction or means one-side communication was there?
It's all about the communication, yeah. It's all about the communication, presentation skills, teamwork and everything. There are many students, around 200 students who are placed with 3 mentors. And they were dividing us into teams and we used to discuss what to do, what not, like how to do everything. Yeah, it's just like the orientation and everyone needs that. You can't just go through the company and get crash it. We need something orientation.
After the studies, you need to know about the culture of the company and particular like that, is it?
Yeah.
So what they explain you about the company so that our students, those who are enthusiastic, IBM can refer you for that?
They explained how IBM can benefit you. It's like we can work from home whenever we need time, and the women are mostly benefited from IBM because we get free cab services and we get so many of maternity leaves for the women. It's around 26 weeks.
Exactly. And that is important for females. They are working for the community, so when they are working for organization, that is important. Exactly, I understand.
Yeah. They provide at most security for the women.
Exactly.
That really is very good. And that's it. I mean, those are the benefits we could get. Okay. Yeah, and it's also a good paying company right now.
It's a very branded company. So.
Yeah.
And anything else you want to describe me so that our students, those who are preparing from the first, second year, so they will get the benefit from it. So what you can suggest them?
What I can suggest is get any company, be confident and you'll crack it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Interview tips, like interview means how you prepared me, only the your soft skills training was enough for it, and your technical section means MOOCs is enough, I think, is it? MOOCs, online training is enough.
It's not like that. I mean, for coding section, let us say, it's never about the programming language you are learning. It's the algorithm you have, it's the pseudocode you are having. So it's not always about the programming language. You can get through any language, but just think it as a subject which you are interested or not. If you are interested, you'll get through it.
Yes, definitely. That's the most important thing.
Yeah.
And what means the student, those who are of different backgrounds, suppose mechanical engineers are also interested in switching to the software field. What you can suggest them so that they will get benefit from your this experience with you?
For them, just learn is basics at least required for the company. When you go through the company website, they will also give you the requirements, like what they are expecting from you, and do you have it? If not, try now, try learning that. You can apply further also, there'll be openings coming and coming, so you can apply whenever you're ready. Just think once, like, I mean, test yourself, are you ready to face this world or not?
Yes, definitely. For me, self-enthusiasm is the most important key, right?
Yeah.
So, means that you have, and means some any other branch, those who want to switch to the software world, they can also, but if they have, be for that, is it?
Yeah, anyone can do this. Just be confident and answer, even if it's right or wrong, just be confident and answer.
Okay, thank you, Jami, for your precious time. Definitely, we industry.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you. The industry said, IHSPT means many students are allied with us, so they are asking for the interview. So, definitely, it will be benefit for those students. Thank you so much again.
Thank you so much for taking your time and interviewing me. I think it's gonna be a huge success for you as well. Yeah. And for all who are watching this, all the best for your career. And thank you.
Thank you so much, Amir. You have a nice day.